So we're back to talk more about what do you got me doing here? I don't know. Everything's fucked up. Do you want to get off the computer right now? Because I'm lonely. Yeah? Yeah, I'm lonely. Wanna die. Do you want to die? Yeah, I kind of want to die. That would be my dream. You want to get off the computer for the day? Yeah. But we did have to address what we saw. And here's the thing. This, in the earlier video, someone accused Lena of being triggered by the concept of my love for Yoko Ono. Triggered negatively, right? We all love each other, right? We all love each other. Case in point, here's a great picture that that illustrates, you know, the connection and how we all feel about each other. Did that even post? Hold on. This picture really says it all. That we, you know, this is more of our Lena and John psychedelic artwork, and it says "I love you," and there's the connection. Okay, if you don't understand this photograph, if you don't understand the symbolism there and the angels and the psychic connections and the cosmic factor, you're not going to understand Lena and John and Yoko. You're not going to understand it. You won't understand it. So stop accusing. All right, John, what are you going to get? What the hell's going on here? All right. Because I don't like to see. You got upset. I did. I said he called the. Oh, don't say it. Stupid cow. All right, easy does it. Don't have to come down on the cows now. Oh, cows are fine. I never liked that saying, stupid cow. Mm. I love cows. However, this woman, she's dead now. She crossed over. Do you have a connection with her? She had to come back down. All right, we're watching a documentary on cults. We're watching all different cults. This woman called herself Mother God. It was the cult of Mother God. Does this look like Mother God to you? Sucking down colloidal silver like it's fucking ginger ale, she ends up giving herself liver disease and dying. But before she did that, she was running around saying she was Mother God. She, okay, you gotta watch the documentary. Yeah, first of all, when we first started watching it early on, you know, she's an attractive girl and she had her own YouTube channel and she got people interested in her being Mother God, right? Yeah, this was once in a not too long before this picture was taken. She was a very attractive woman. But all these people believed her and started sending her money. She became rich and wealthy in like no time. Started a commune in some fucking, I don't know. She kept bouncing around to Hawaii. She could afford to do all this stuff, but she's sucking down booze all day, smoking weed, sucking down booze. Has a boyfriend that's doing fucking meth, right? And people are still sending her money. She's drinking colloidal silver because guess what? They supposedly manufacture it in the basement or whatever of the commune where she's running, holding court. What the fuck was this broad's name again? Oh, okay. Says she's in touch with Robin Williams, who is like her fucking galactic partner. Yes. It is my contention that she thought Robin, are you there?
Am I here?
Right. Mm.
Dragging my name through the mud.
Right.
She's doing channeled writing from Robin Williams, and somehow that gave the whole project credence. Everyone's like, well, she's talking to Robin Williams. Here's my question, John. We're going to send her money because she's talking around. First of all, I never asked anybody for one penny out there. Check all the videos. Not one dime. I don't want your fucking money. Why would I want it? I come out of the woodwork to tell about my relationship with John Lennon. It has brought me nothing but fucking nonsense from idiots out there. No money. Maybe I need to drink a lot of silver and do this. Fucking smart.
And I got the wrong guy. I said, Lorne Greene, you could have. Yeah. Lorne Greene. Hi, Lorne. We were waiting for this rant, Lena. Well, we were watching you watch this video last night, and it was everything we could do that John could not bust out. Right, because in the beginning of the thing, I was like, am I like this woman? Am I like this woman? No wonder people fucking think I'm sick. Nobody thinks you're sick. Yeah, right. What they accuse you of and what they actually think are two different things. So let's get that straight. Can I get a witness? Yeah. Mom, go on. You're on a tear. We want to hear you talk about this. All right. Okay. Goes from bad to worse with this one. We're not done watching this thing yet. Mm-hmm. Okay. The cult of Mother God. The audacity to call yourself, I am Mother God. That is who I am. And therefore, you got to send me money because God wants me to have God. But then she says that the meth guy is Father God. The meth guy who's wearing one of them fucking ankle bracelets because he's been under arrest. And she explains that away by saying that she is definitely Mother God and he is definitely Father God because it's proof that you can love even the most creepy characters and Father God is one of them. What is this teaching? Well, thankfully, not everyone in the world adhered to this cult. Right. I'm starting to wonder what kind of world this is, that there would be even one person following this woman, much less a couple of thousand. You're only starting to wonder now. Mother God, you're so beautiful. Wait, did she come down to... She's back down. She has to go back down. She had to go right back down. That was heavy duty penalties, claiming to be Mother God and doing all that bullshit. You kidding me with that? Right. God loves her, but she also abandoned her three children. She got pregnant by three different guys and left all the kids with her mother and took off when they were little. And all those kids were happier without her. They even said so. Mother God, if she had children, if she was incarnated down here on Earth and had children, do you think she would leave them with Grandma and take off to go drink a lot of booze and let's not forget the colloidal silver, right? Listen, colloidal silver is really good for you, like a teaspoon a day, maybe, and then you can skip a day here and there. She was drinking like a gallon. Her liver shut down. Meth guy is carrying her around like she's the Queen of Sheba because she lost use of her arms and legs because of fucking... Look, this is disgusting, okay? You're not put on Earth to behave this way. And it seemed like she had a decent childhood, except she had, like, eating disorder. She had a stepmother who was mean to her. They touched on that. Well, that had some effect on her. Right. Yeah, it just goes to show you, like, she had a very loving mother, and her sisters really adored her, and they did everything for her. And she still left all her kids without a word. She was at a dinner party with her whole family. And at the end of the night, they're like, where'd what's-her-face go? And they never saw her again. She never said a fucking word. This is someone who snapped out. Look at this person, Chris. Look at this lady. This is the thing we're watching now.
This is colloidal silver lady?
Yeah.
And that's what her face turned into from the court.
Yeah, and she was like a young, beautiful, like almost looked like Marilyn Monroe. Yeah. Oh. Absolutely. Chunky, big tits. Right.
She blew it.
When she hooked up with Meth Guy with the ankle bracelet, I was like, whoa. And everyone in the commune, I love when she starts screaming, everyone in the commune is like, okay, he can be our Father God. What? What is wrong with you fucking people? They're still fucking talking like she's Mother God. She dropped dead. Okay, she dropped dead. Okay, wait. Here's where Lena starts teeing off like she becomes Howard Stern. Right. I tell you, I understand his way of reporting because you can't even think of all the things fast enough that your mind goes insane. My mind was going crazy. Yes. She starts dying, and she says the reason she is dying, not the colloidal silver, not the tons of booze, which she is still imbibing. Right. I would like a Mai Tai. I can't walk. My arms are falling off. But someone give me a straw and a Mai Tai. All right, mother, because you're God. They're saying that the reason she is going down is not because of all of these things that she is doing to her body. She is going down because she is taking on the pain and the suffering of the entire world. Because why? She's Mother God. She's and they're all thanking her. Thank God she's doing this. Because could you imagine how painful it would be if we had to go through this? So they set her up in this really nice bed. And they're all bringing her fucking chicken wings. Oh, that's another thing. Mother God is like a carnivore, like you can't believe. Yeah. But after a while, she can't eat anymore because, you know, nothing is going through her body correctly. So it's like, oh, liquid lunch, colloidal silver, and break, keep them Mai Tais coming. Liquid lunch. I got angry watching this. Mm. And we're not done. I can't wait. Yeah. Why are you laughing? This is a very sad story, but at the same time, Lena, it's hysterical. And it tells the best part. John Lennon is Ashtar, according to her Robin Williams reports. John Lennon is Ashtar. He is the head. He is the navigator of the spaceship that is going to come down from the galactic universe and eventually bring her home. Right. His name is Ashtar, and he is a pilot. I love being part of this. Right. Hi, baby. Did you get home safe? Ouch. Oh, now what? Oh, guess gotta go back down for Lena, the other nut. That's not funny. Hmm. So I said to John, but she actually starts, Lena is so paranoid about how people have made her feel that she starts thinking that she is like this woman because she takes colloidal silver and talks to Robin Williams. I've only spoken to Robin Williams. Well, I'm here right now. I really wish you would speak to me. All right, Robin. How do you feel about this? First of all, you still will not watch my movies. No, I don't watch your movies, Robin. I'm sorry. You even got a free pass to watch all the Mork and Mindy's. I never watched it when it was on. I turned it off after a second. It was ridiculous. Maybe that's where she got the idea, though, because you were like a space guy in that show. I'm sure that's where she got the idea. You think so? I'm positive. So when she crossed over, Robin, yes, were you the, I was right there. And I said, you fucked up, honey. That wasn't me. Oh my God. Right. She was talking to entities and they are very convincing. Oh my God. That is sends a chill of dread through me. Yeah. Because that's what happens when you are a user. And I learned this because I went through life as a user, and when I came to the other side, I had to help people stop being users. If she would have been talking to me, I would have helped to guide her to sobriety, because that is what I do now. That is what I do for souls that are lost, because I was one of those souls. This is so overwhelming. Oh my God. Just like Hiram, right, we're on the same league, me and your brother Hiram. We are recovery angels. If she would have been talking to me, I wouldn't have been telling her to recruit people. I wouldn't have been telling her to shop for more money from fragile minds. I wouldn't have been telling her to leave her children behind because her mission was with me. I would have been getting her to the nearest AA. And then to a good psychiatrist. If she would have asked for that kind of help, she would have gotten it. but she was too busy telling everyone that she was God. And there is almost no greater sin. In fact, that's right at the top. That's really right at the top. God was merciful to her and sent her back down in pretty much the same state as a young girl to do it all over again. Is she at all well known? We'll bring that up later, and you'll be surprised to find out who she is. I'm trying to rack. You won't find out by racking your brain. We will tell you who she is. Is it Mindy? Pam Dauber? No, she's no. I know. You, Lena, you don't have to watch my movies. You have a lot of other things to watch. You got this thing to watch,
right?
So was it funny that she did? How did you find it that she was using? I think that it's a good example that she was using a famous person's name and that she was tapping into all the celebrity personalities that were supposedly helping her out in her journey, because there are many imposters out there and they are very convincing, and they are especially convincing if you have a mind that is not sober. You are willing to believe anything and everything, and these entities are real. They're not imaginary. They are very convincing and they are very real. And they convinced her, and it was said several times during the documentary, they convinced her that the booze was medicinal. Yes. And she believed it. That it was necessary for her to use it as a grounding tool. Mm-hmm. They will convince you. They will convince you. And Lena, you had dark entities around you for almost your entire life convincing you that your alcohol and drug use was merely recreational. It took a long time for the team to really fully get through and really take you out of commission and shake you up. And how? Right, right. We tried to do that. And at one point, well, you tell it. Yes, at one point during the documentary, and then I found out it was many times after that, she started saying to her followers, she started having these fits of screaming like The Exorcist. That was us. That was us saying, leave this woman alone. Get out of her. We were having an exorcism for her on the other side. This is fascinating. I'm so fascinated by this. Yes. She asked her followers, has this whole thing been bullshit? I mean, am I really that far gone? I thought I was Mother God and it's a lie. I'm thinking, I really am fucked up. I don't think I'm Mother God. And they all said to her, no, you're Mother God. You are. Because they liked the setup there. They loved the setup there. They were, right, they were now having all their booze and their free ride, and they were living in her fancy house on her money that people were sending her. And part of her was trying to say, maybe I got to turn this thing around and go back to my kids and start doing something different with my life than thinking I'm Mother God. This might be a big mistake. And her followers told her, no. You are Mother God, and we're not going to let you think anything else. Don't be crazy. You're in touch with Robin Williams and the galactic team. Don't doubt yourself, Mother. That's what the evil people want you to do. That's what the evil souls want you to do. They want you to doubt yourself, Mother. Mother God would never doubt herself. Mother God would never be strung out on booze all fucking day long. Mother God would sit with a squirrel on her head and write beautiful songs and be married to a righteous man. The real father. Amen, Lena. I love you. I love you. Testify, girl. I will testify. We have to pick out a song now. All right. But, okay. But before we pick a song, we're going to go back into the lib before Lena forgets. Oh, right. They call Dr. Phil. The mother of this girl calls Dr. Phil, right? Because she's like at the end of her rope. She's like, maybe Dr. Phil can talk to her and we can figure out what's going on with what's her face here. My daughter, I want her home. What's her face? Yeah. The fuck was that girl's name anyway?
Mother God.
No, I can't think of what her name was. Amy Carlson. How funny that her name was Amy, right? I'm always talking about Amy. So Dr. Phil's like, sure, I'll do a show, because Dr. Phil is a fucking shill, man. He loves fucking doing crazy shit like that. He doesn't want to help her. The mother thinks that Dr. Phil is going to be like the help. So the mother says, call her. Call her and tell her you're interested. Let's do it this way, Dr. Phil, because if I tell her I'll be there, she won't be there. So let's do it like you call her and pretend that you're interested in her cult and you want to be maybe a member or something, right? Like, act like you believe her, right? And they actually do this. And she's all excited, Miss fucking turning blue here. She's all excited to be on, and she's like in a gurney at this point. She can't even fucking get up. And she's like, I'll do it. I always thought it would be Oprah who would call me, but he called me first. She's excited. Dr. Phil called me first. I love Dr. Phil. His show is great. And I can't wait to be on it. And like, now I'm finally going to get the recognition that I'm Mother God and all this crap. Amazing. She's so fucking crazy and delusional. They're all excited. Dr. Phil calls up. She's on the tele-fucking Zoom thing. And then her mother shows up on the show. Come home. She was so up. She was like, come home. Your children need you. And she was fucking furious. She was beyond herself with mortification on the Dr. Phil while she was still being filmed for the Dr. Smith. Lost in space. While she's being... she's with Dr. Smith out in space. Robin Williams, Dr. Smith. What's the difference? Dr. Phil, Dr. Smith. Everyone's a doctor. Dr. Mom. Dr. Mother God, with the fucking in the basement mixing up the medicine. I don't even know. So she goes nuts, right? She goes nuts after the show is done taping. She didn't go nuts on the show. She was kind of like mortified and very quiet while her mother was crying to her to come home. And Dr. Phil's going, so what are you going to do, Amy? Are you going to come home now? Or do you think you're still Mother God? And why do you think you're Mother God? And are you really turning blue? Or what's going on? I don't even know what the hell he's saying. We're going to look for that show later so we can see the full episode of Dr. Phil talking to this fucking lunatic and her family. And but after the show is over, she's like, those motherfuckers fooled me! It's like, if you're Mother God, you should have known. You should have seen that coming, right? Didn't your angels tell you? Because that's what she always says. My angels told me. And everyone's like, yes, that's why she's Mother God. The angels told her. All these things keep going wrong. Her house keeps burning down because some idiot was fucking smoking pot and burning sage in the backyard where there are these wildfires brewing. And the whole house burns down in 5 seconds. And they all escape by some kind of canoe. You got to see this documentary. They all escape in this canoe. Mother God and fucking crackhead Bob. They're flying away from the burning building. And they're because they're filming everything. They're flying away from the burning building. And they're screaming, God loves us. We're safe. You just lost your whole fucking house, you idiot. Because someone's burning sage over there. Man. To supposedly ward off the evil spirits. You're all the evil spirits. That's what happened. Idiots. You're lucky the canoe doesn't go down. But actually, you would have been fucking better off. Because then she drops dead and she's laying in bed like a mummy. And they're all around her saying, the body's still warm. She sees she is Mother God because the body doesn't get cold. Because you're living in the fucking, tropics. The body's rotting away. That's maggots you feel warming the body, dear. That is not the love of Mother God. You got a dead body on your hands. And you're all sitting there fucking sniffing it all day. This is a sick world. And you guys got to get Cinemax. It's free this month. You got to go on, subscribe to free Cinemax. No, just this week, right? It's all a lot of cults, and it's really interesting. There's another one called the Way Down cult, which is led by this woman, Crazy Guggenstein. I don't know. She looks kind of like Tammy Faye Baker and a combo of Lonnie Anderson, you know? Mm. But her hair is like up to the ceiling. Mm. And she's skinny as hell. And she's all about, you know, starving people into Christly submission. And she ended up dying. You guys got to watch it. The Way Down cult, spelled W-E-I-G-H as in weigh yourself and way down, right? So, and that's it, right, honey? Oh, yes, it's really, truly amazing. All right, now we can find a song. All right, so you're determined to get this song done today. Gotcha. Talk about being mama's pearl. Ankle chills up and down my spine. We kiss for food, then you draw the line. Oh baby, cause your mama told you that love ain't right. But don't you know love is part of life now, yeah. Mama's pearl, let down those cultures. Give my love over, find what you made me say. Let me give your heart a twirl. Don't get me wishing. Woo-hoo. All right, I'm getting into it. You want my love? Yes, you do, do, do. God. No, my loving is a true, true, true now, baby. But your conscience tells you that love is wrong. Don't you know love it never hurt no one? Oh, mama's pearl, let down those girls just to give my love a whirl. Find out what you're missing. Oh, baby, good girl, let down those girls just to let your heart a twirl. Don't keep me wishing. Oh, let yourself go. It's up to you, now let it flow, yeah. Just let yourself go. Now, 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 now. Oh, give it to me. God, what you need. Let's fall in love. Ooh, what you been missing? Good ego. Let down your girl just to give your heart a twirl. Why don't you love me? I got what you want, I got what you need, I got what you want, I got what you need. Let down, love in love, let's fall in love. Oh baby, let's fall in love. Just let yourself go, let your good love flow. Oh, give it to me now, I said what you need. Let's fall in love. Let's fall in love.